A radiant figure in embossed satin enters this vast auditorium, moving amongst loyal members of the great British public. On occasions such as this, she has always seemed to possess dignity, grace, and above all, medicated hand wash. And now the Queen makes her way to the throne, where she will address the nation.
My lords, ladies, and commoners, I am most pleased to speak to all of you this evening, and as I look out around this theatre, I see it is filled with national treasures. Sir Simon, Alicia, David, and of course, me. Sorry, Camilla. Of course, you know I jest. I've always enjoyed a good joke, like Simon's hairdresser. It is important to remember that even if you have no talent, no charisma, and an appalling dress sense, you can still be on Britain's Got Talent as a judge. Recently, we all celebrated the birth of a son to one of the nation's favorite couples. Hearty congratulations, Stacey Solomon and Joe Smith. We have so many grandchildren and great-grandchildren that Prince Philip and I struggle to remember their names. Only the other day, I said to Harry, what's the name of the one who dribbles all the time and wets the bed? And he said, Granddad. I may be 93, but I'm actually dying with the kids. I binge watch television, or as we call it, Netflix and Phil. We often lose ourselves in the box set of The Real Housewives of Windsor. But my favorite show is The Crown. It's all about one and what one gets up to. I still think they should have called it The One Show. In these troubling times, I believe we should all have confidence in this great nation. House prices may fall, but I can assure you that every single person in Britain will own a house. It's the one I live in. And you're most welcome anytime. £24 per adult and £13.50 for children. And if you're becoming bored listening to a pensioner who dresses ridiculously and is paid millions for doing absolutely nothing, maybe you shouldn't have Simon on the judging panel. Three cheers for the Queen. Hip hip.
Hooray!
Hip hip.
Hooray!
Hip hip.
Hooray!
And may God bless you all.
Hammersmith Apollo, make some noise! Great to be back, great to be back, ladies and gentlemen. It's been a while, it's been a while. I've been enjoying fatherhood. I've been enjoying it. Roman is now 10 months old. Ladies and gentlemen, he's 10 months. And like any new parent, I think the first thing we want to do is give our child something that we missed out on in our own childhood, right? Yeah? For that, for me, that one thing is the opportunity to play. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, when you have African parents, playing is not allowed, ladies and gentlemen. Right? I remember all my friends were allowed to play, and every Saturday morning at 8 a.m., they would come outside my house and they'd be like, Mr. Anim, can Koja come and play out? I'd be standing next to my dad inside the house, and he would say, go downstairs and tell them you are not here. Old enough to go to school, I hope he has fun games like I did. My favorite game in school was Kiss Chase, right? I loved it, right? But Kiss Chase had very simple rules, right? The boys would chase the girls and they'll give them a kiss on the cheek, okay? But you could never catch the pretty girls, could you? Pretty girls had pace in it, yeah? Girls like Amanda and Alicia, they were fast. They're the reason I've got asthma today. You chase them all over the playground, you couldn't catch them for nothing. But ladies and gentlemen, then there were girls that looked like David and Simon. Yes, and you chase those girls for 2 seconds, right? And they'll always fall over by accident. It was frustrating. And I also think further, what kind of job is Roman going to have when he's older? Because ladies and gentlemen, every job I had before I did stand up, I absolutely hated. Hated it, right? Guys, has anybody in here hated their job so bad that you practice your sick voice? Yeah. You know what I'm talking about, innit? And for some reason, the bathroom is always the best place to practice. Our sickness sounds amazing in the bathroom, right? And whether you're male or female, we all had the same sick voice. Hello. Ladies and gentlemen, I practiced my sick voice for so long, I forgot what the excuse was. Confident, right? I was ready to meet my boss, where I was like, boss.
Hello? Hello, boss?
Yes?
I can't come in today.
What's wrong with you?
I twisted my ankle.
So why does it sound like that?
I don't know.
In the first audition, ladies and gentlemen, you may have heard me talk about my father, right? And I gave him a little bit of stick. However, I've got to tell you a good moment where my dad delivered. He delivered. At the age of 16, my dad allowed me to go to my first ever house party, ladies and gentlemen, right? You know, you remember your first house party. It's emotional, right? I turned to dad. I said, Dad, Michael's having a party. Can I go?
Party? For what?
Cause it's gonna be fun.
You can have fun here.
Yeah, Dad, but I wanna go over there and have fun.
Okay, I will let you go. But tonight you will be Cinderella. I want you back in this house at 12 midnight. Not 12:01. Not 11:59, 12 midnight.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm 16 years old. I get to go to my favorite thing, which is the party, right?
It was so good, I came home at 3 a.m. in the morning. Ladies and gentlemen, I was so scared because at night, everything sounds loud. At 3 a.m. in the morning, I got to my front door, I opened it. I creeped upstairs towards my bedroom. Ladies and gentlemen, it felt like the stairs was grassing on me. Guess who's just come home? I was so scared. I ran into my bedroom, I went under the covers, and as soon as I turned off my bedroom light, all I heard was...
So you want to come home late?
Ladies and gentlemen, my dad was hiding in my bed. X-rays, this is a bruise.
Thank you very much.
Good evening, Apollo. Oh, what a lovely, lovely welcome. I do enjoy a warm hand on my entrance, so thank you so much. Indeed. There's been a lot happening since I last saw you. I've had a breast reduction. Do you know, it's marvellous. I feel so much more confident now I've just got the two. And I've had some really, really nice comments. Some people have compared me to a female Peter Kay. And when I saw myself on telly, I looked like I'd eaten Peter Kay. So I've gone back to the gym, I got on the rowing machine, drifted for an hour. It's a start. And I'm on the Slim Fast. I know, it's brilliant. Strawberry milkshake, vanilla milkshake, chocolate milkshake. And they really wash down your Big Mac so well. Right, stop now. Come on. We're on a live show. So anyway... I bet you're wondering how my little girl is. Yeah? Well, she's alive, so I'm told. She's just turned 3. No, don't say that, because it's not a fun age. It's hard. It's hard work. Has anybody got any obviously, yeah, 3-year-olds. It's frightening. So what I've done is, because I'm not rich and I can't afford therapy, I've written a song about it instead. Do you want to hear it? I'm glad you said yes, because I can't dance. So I'm going to do you this. Here we go. You can join in if you know it, but you won't know it because I wrote it. Oh. I've got a toddler, she rules my life. She's like a miniature Margaret Thatcher, but with more strife. I say yes, she says no, a million times a day. I was thinking of joining Mum's Net, but instead I've joined AA. I've got a toddler, she likes to eat. I'm like a personal chef and a personal maitre d'. It's like an episode of Kitchen Nightmares every single chuffing day. If a chicken nuggets touch a ketchup, there's always hell to pay. I wouldn't change it for the world, the war cry of mum and dad. I can't remember my life before when I didn't have a smashed iPad. I wanna run off to Ibiza with a glow stick in my hand. Swig a bottle of tequila, dance naked on the sand. I've got a toddler, my hair's a mess, because it takes me 6 straight hours to get her dressed. One shoe on, one shoe off, knickers on her head. By the time we're finally ready, it's nearly time for bed. I've got a toddler, she always waits to have a full-on mental meltdown in a public place. I suddenly become a ventriloquist when I'm trying not to lose my mind. It's only 8:30 in the morning, is that too soon for wine? I wouldn't change it for the world, the war cry of mum and dad. I can't remember my life before when I didn't have a smashed iPad. I wanna run off to Ibiza with a glow stick in my hand. Swig a bottle of tequila, dance naked on the sand. I wouldn't change it for the world. I wouldn't change it for the world. Sometimes I would get me on the plane before I go insane. Before I go insane.
galaxy far, far away, at a television studio somewhere within the M25, a first-rate impressionist made a second-rate movie starring all your favorite characters. It was so cheap, its entire budget wouldn't pay for Simon Cowell's dental whitener. This is Return of the Rodi.
Simon Cowell, your teeth are too bright for the dark side.
Yoda is here. Use the source, Luke.
They traveled in time.
Great Scott, Marty! We need to go back to the future! We need to find something, Marty. Wait a minute. Somebody's following from the space-time continuum.
Hasta la vista, baby. I'm doing it.
Get out! Get out! I'm here to terminate Donald Trump.
It's not fake news. It's not fake news. The Terminator was shooting at me. And my security guard, he said, Donald, duck.
Oh, yeah, baby, son.
Get the duck on that roller coaster.
Oh, no, I will do.
Music from Sia. Now you can't see her. It's not a superhero, even shorter than Declan Donnelly.
Buzz Lightyear, to the rescue. To infinity and high heels and beyond.
Welcome to the Shrek in the Swamp karaoke disco party. Oops, I did it again. Broccoli Spears, oh yeah. Oh, that'll be the phone then.
Hello, have you been sold PPI insurance?
Listen, pal, you're going the right way for a smack bottom. I'm gonna come round your house and I will pee-pee in your eye. What do you say to that, donkey? I'm gonna make some waffles. Oh yes, Shrek. Hey, oh look, it's Pinocchio. Hello, Pinocchio.
Hi, I'm a real boy. David Williams is my favorite judge.
Hello, and welcome to Mrs. Brown's boys. This is my Brexit bra, because everybody wants me out of it, but nobody wants to face the consequences.
What this movie needs is a superhero.
With great power comes great responsibility. Who am I? I'm Spider-Man. Visit my website.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Good evening, Great Britain. It's nice to be here. Tonight, I'm going to try something a bit special. I'm going to attempt to predict the National Lottery. But before I do, I need to warm up a little bit. So, Alicia, I wonder if you mind helping me. In a moment, I want you to be totally spontaneous. That means you do something without thinking about it, a little bit like Simon when he got dressed before he came out tonight. Sorry, I'm kidding, Simon. I support charity shops. You're doing a great job. It's never easy, is it, when you're between sizes? So, what do you do for me? Alicia, if you would please, it's when I say now, spontaneously, without thinking about it, shout out any number between 1 and 5. When I say now, here okay. We go. Ladies and gentlemen, the power of the mind. Alicia, now!
4!
Look at that! Be honest! Thank you. Straight through to the final. So, ladies and gentlemen, the National Lottery numbers, the winning numbers are 3, 12, 24, 48, 49, and 53. Thank you very much. Good night. No, the thing is, they are the winning lotteries. The problem is, I don't know when. You see, the thing is, the truth is, I don't do the lottery very often. I do it sort of about twice a week at most. And every lottery ticket I've ever bought is in that ball over there. I don't do it very often at all. But I would love to have £6 million, or as Simon's dentist calls it, a deposit. I am very good at predicting people. I predicted there'd be people here tonight, and I was right. I think I could predict what would happen tonight if we played an imaginary game of the National Lottery this evening. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to have six numbers chosen between 1 and 59. Those are the National Lottery numbers. And this is my prediction of what I think is about to happen. Now, I don't want dull numbers. I want interesting numbers. You know, like 7, the age of Deck when he stopped growing. Or, You might want to tell me how many dresses you've tried on in this last week, David. So we'll start with you, David. Give me an interesting number between 1 and 59.
43.
43. Fascinating. I'm really interested. Wonderful. Alicia, give me another interesting number between 1 and 59.
16.
16. You went for your age and you were miles off. Amanda, give me an interesting number between 1 and 59.
58.
58, very, very good. And David, give me an interesting number. Sorry, Simon.
Simon.
Sorry. You just had that little grin on your face. It made me think you were David.
Simon.
Yeah, excellent. When you smile, I know it's you. That's better. We've got to get on. Come on. So, what's your number?
Number one, darling.
Number one? Excellent. That's how many millions he's earned since I walked on stage, actually. And, Ant, would you give me a number between 1 and 59?
26, darling.
26. Good one, 26. And, Deck, give me a number.
My birthday, 25.
25. Jolly, jolly good. OK. Now, I've got to get my prediction. There's no suspicious moves. I'm going to get my little prediction. Ant and Deck, would you come and join me just over here on stage? Give them a big round of applause. OK. Would you do me... Did you come up all the steps? Oh, you did. OK, would you read my prediction out to the audience?
Yes, sir.
One number at a time.
My prediction is...
Yes.
2.
Yes.
No.
6. No.
0.
That wasn't an option, to be honest. No.
1. 20.
20. No.
19.
No. That's annoying, isn't it? I mean, one number's not bad. No, I don't know what's going wrong. Those aren't the numbers. That's the date. That's the date. The 26th of the 1st, 2019.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Can you look a little bit excited? That was the date I did my audition at the London Palladium. Uh-huh. And I felt so lucky after the audition. I bought a lottery ticket. Get excited. I bought a lottery ticket. And I chose 6 numbers that I thought you would choose tonight. And I can prove it. Remember I said I keep all my lottery tickets?
Yes.
They're over there in that bowl. Would you just go over to that bowl
and
just empty them out of the table?
Yes. Okay, what are we looking for?
Here's what I want you to do. I want you to look for the lottery tickets that's dated the 26th of January 2019. Don't damage that ball, I borrowed it off Simon's hairdresser.
Yes.
Have we got it?
26.
Wonderful, bring it over here. Is that the 26th of January?
January 19.
2019. Don't let me touch it. Okay, will you do me a favour? One at a time, slowly, guys. You got the date right. Can any of you see what you're doing here?
Is that the right one?
Don't know if it is.
No, that's not the right one. No. You got the wrong one.
Oh.
Yeah, I know why you got the wrong one.
Why?
It's because I didn't put it in the bowl.
Ah.
No, it's just a special ticket. I would never put it in the bowl. In fact, I keep it special.
Okay.
I keep it special. You see, in my wallet, I always carry that special ticket with me. It's got memories. And I've got it in here, a little zippered compartment. Every magician's had a zippered compartment. It's a rule. And inside there, you'll notice I've got a little envelope.
Oh, yes.
Okay. And if you read that, look, if you read what it says, my
BGT lottery ticket.
All right. Will you do me a favour? Will you tear that envelope open for me? Tear it open.
Yes.
And get abandoned.
Okay. Here we go. It's torn.
Wonderful. Take out what's inside. It should be a lottery ticket. Yeah. Is that right?
It is a lottery ticket.
Unfold it and read the 6 numbers that are printed on it. One at a time.
26th of January, 19. Your numbers. 1.
Yes!
16.
Yes!
25.
Yes!
26. 43.
Yes!
And 58.
Yes!
Tell you what, my face looked pretty big on that screen, didn't it? Do you know what? It's so good to be here tonight. I normally just do auditions, so this is massive for me. And tonight, my first bit does feature my own choreography. It's now time, ladies and gentlemen, for some semi-professional magic. Hit the music, let's do this. See the judges. How are we doing, judges? All right? Oh, I went to my doctor's yesterday. My doctor said to me, Graham, you're too fat. How much do you weigh? I said, 18 stone. He said, what's the lightest you should be? And I said, 6 pounds, 2 ounces. Pull this case here. Don't touch it. Now, good evening, judges. You all look lovely, stunning, beautiful tonight. Now, Amanda. Oh. Magic Amanda. Remember me, love?
Yes,
now.
I do.
I did notice when you all walked in tonight, you all look good, right? All of you, even you, right? All look good. But Amanda, you had a little bit of dirt on your left shoe and you're letting the side down. But don't worry, I'm going to clean it for you using magic. Can I borrow your left shoe, Amanda?
Oh,
careful, love, right?
Hang on.
There we go, she's taking that off. What can I tell you while we're doing that? Oh, yeah, I've been a diet recently. I say a diet. The only crisps my girlfriend buys now are Pringles because my hands are too fat to fit in the tube. I'll just borrow your shoe.
You're going to be nice to
I'll
my
be very
shoe.
Nice to you, yeah.
That's like a week's wages
yeah,
on that
what's
shoe.
What's that? Armani and Navy. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to take Amanda's shoe and I'm going to clean the dirt off it in a very special, magical way. This is a special shoe cleaning device that I invented myself. And tonight, I am going to use the shoe cleaning device to make sure Amanda's shoe is completely clean. Trust me, Amanda, I am a magician. First, it's time for some danger. It's time for some fire eating. Let's go! Yes! Yeah! Danger! With you, I didn't quite get a plan. Now, don't worry, Amanda. All it needs a little polish, you'll be as good as new. Look. All right, I'll tell you what. I'll make it disappear. Are you ready? Ladies and gentlemen, this is real magic. The shoe has now... It didn't go like that in rehearsals. Now, I'll tell you what. Amanda's shoe has disappeared. But where could he be? You're not going to believe this, but Amanda is back on your foot. Have a look. Well, of course you ain't. Why's she even looking? But inside this case, there is something incredible. It's a long way up and down there for a fat bloke, I'm telling you. Inside this case is something incredible you're not going to expect. That's right. It's another case. And inside this case is something truly incredible. That's right. It's another case. But inside this case is something incredible and unique. In fact, it's probably unique to you, Amanda. Let's check it's the right shoe. Smells like yours. Now this, ladies and gentlemen, is Amanda's shoe. Thank you very much. Good night.
To the Apollo taking a selfie. I couldn't remember the backstage number to get back in. 5476. No, that's your pin number, Barbara. Look after that for me, love, my bag and coat. Cos I'm on. Everybody all right? Are you? Are you, love? Are you? OK. Everybody, I've been in a right pigging state since the audition. How are you? How are you, Amanda, love? Are you all right, love?
I'm good, my
I've
darling.
Been TTU, Amanda, totally tizzed up. I'll tell you what happened. Thanks for laughing, love, some money and mother. I'll tell you what happened yesterday. I was doing 80 up a one-way cul-de-sac. I shouldn't even been driving that pigging bus. We're in the Vida. Hi, Alicia.
Hello,
$6.99. And I've been trying to get in tip-top condition, you know. I've gone vegan. Well, I say vegan. Are you a vegan, love? It's good, isn't it? But I've had some quinoa with my steak bake. Is that all right? And David, of course, I'll be seeing you again Wednesday for hot yoga. But I want you to do, I want you to sew up that little hole in your leotard, if you don't mind. No, because it gave my friend, Lucky Mary, quite a stir, you know, doing his downward facing dog. She thought her look had changed, all right. I'm sorry, Simon, I can't look at you because of my husband. I'm very sorry, he's very jealous. He is, Ken, he's jealous. Kenny's watching this, you know, in the club with everybody. And if he sees me looking at Simon full frontal in the semis, he'll go mad. Do you mind if I just have a word? Ken? Right, I know you're watching. It's me. It's Barbara. Now, listen. There's nothing going on with me and Simon Callow. All right? All right, nice to see you. I feel better now, said I hear to see you. Do you know, that's the second time today I've tried to ignore somebody, then I said I and it all got better. The first time, right, I was in the supermarket looking at mothballs. I know, fame's changed you, Barbara. When suddenly, my neighbour, lovely Mrs. Patel, I see her coming out the corner of my eye and I thought, I don't want her to see me, you know, I'm all tizzed up, I'm on telly tonight. And we've all done it, and if you've never ignored somebody you know in a supermarket and run away from them, maybe it's you they're running away from. So I turn me back really quick, you know, try and pretend I'm studying the fat and salt content of a tin of peas. She comes round the back, she taps me on the shoulder, she goes, "Hiya, Mrs. Nice." I go, "Hiya, Mrs. Patel." Turn round too quick, crick me neck and go, "Do you know where the Swiss rolls are?" I don't know why I said it, but it turned out smashing because she carried me shopping home, which is all we want. Went back to her house, good laugh, neck massage. And she taught me a song and dance for restoration and detizzification, which I'm going to teach you now. Are you up for it? So it goes like this, right? These are the moves. You clap, point forward, back. it. No, right now, there's a lady at the top in salmon pink. It doesn't matter, love, it's very good. If more people were prepared to say we're not sure, can we go through it again? We'd all be able to do fractions by now. So it's very good, we're very grateful to you, and people at home are and all. So it goes like this, are you all right? You clap. You point forward. If you're still clapping, you daft, what am I doing? You do the windows. If you're still clapping, get with the picture, love, and not clapping. Light bulbs. You're clean, sweet, you're clean, sweet. You hold the ceiling up. The girl in yellow, you lot was good. People still, are you loves, all right. Nice suits, it's a shame they shut CNA down, isn't it? So, are we all ready to do it? Smashing, right, everybody stand up now. You can stand up. A nice, lovely, nice soft knees. And smile, cheer your body into things. Change it now, ready, point. That's, yeah, you got it, but my people's eyes, we don't want to go through place direct. Right, windows, look at the energy in this theatre. Forget fracking, we could run the UK. Somebody tell Bez from Happy Mondays, are you ready now for the light bulb? Come on, kids. Beautiful, very nice, very nice. Okay. Right, well, now, where's my coat? It's over there. Don't worry, love, I'll come to you. Right, help me with this now. Right, come on down. Stage diving. Semi-final style. Are you ready? All right, Ice and Deck, you could get down.
German for you there. Do you know, I can't believe I've got this far. I'm in the BGT final. Who would have dreamt it? Who would have thought my daft ditties would get me this far, because I've never had any luck, especially not with fellas, let me tell you. But looking round at who you're sitting with tonight, girls, I think we're all in the same boat. And my mum's desperate for me to find somebody, and she keeps giving me advice, making me go on dates, and she always gives me confidence. She says it's what's on the inside that counts. But what's on the inside of me is a family bucket of KFC, six steak bakes, and a chocolate cake. And she says, Siobhan, you never get a second chance to make a first impression. She doesn't even speak like that, but that's how I hear her voice in my head. So I like to get all dressed up for the first date. And it is a beautiful wedding dress. But I can sing this song that I've written because it's about my mum, and if she heard it, she'd probably give me a slap. But she's not here because she's babysitting. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to see how many of you guys out there recognise your own mums within the lyrics of this song. If it's not one thing, it's your mother.
I love her, but she drives me mad. Never let her loose on your Facebook, or she'll add every friend that you have. She'll spend hours sharing missing dogs from Luton, though she lives 200 miles away. When I pointed this out, I heard her shout, well, he might have jumped on a train. It's not one thing, it's your mother, always giving you the lowdown on who's dead. The latest is Brenda from the Chippy, who choked on a fish cake butty in her bed. When I told my mum I never knew her, she looked at me as if I'd gone quite mad. Don't you remember, in 1983, you walked to Brownies with her instead of your dad? Oh, Mama dear, I love you so, but sometimes you can be a ruddy pain. I don't need to know how well Jackie's daughter's doing, because she puts me to shame. With her high-flying job for perfect kids and a husband who resembles Bradley Cooper, it only makes me want to run to the pub and drink myself into a stupor. It's not one thing, it's your mother, always pointing out when you have piled on weight. She'll bang on and on about healthy eating, but then offer you a massive slice of cake. She will never ever answer her mobile, for it's left on charge at home when she goes out. But if you do the same, she'll call the police and the army to locate your whereabouts. If it's not one thing, it's your mother, asking what the weather's doing round at yours. Then she'll launch into a 30-minute sermon with more detail than the Met Office for sure. But you're a little crazy, ooh, and that is why I am a little bit, ooh, but I love you.
It's the final. But I have one question. I have one question. Why do untidy people love to have people over? I just don't understand it. Do you know what I mean? I really don't understand it. And what confuses me is they invite you confidently, knowing that their house is a mess. Ladies and gentlemen, I know I'm going to be talking about their house at the moment I walk in. Right? I got invited to a dinner party. I walked in, I was like, wow, is this how they live? What is this? Untidy people love to make you comfortable. They've got the cheek to say, take off your jacket, mate, and make yourself at home. No, I'm not staying. I'm just passing through. This house was ridiculous, and I knew they had not cleaned it for years. I sat on the couch. At the back of the couch, I found a marathon bar. A marathon bar. I haven't seen a marathon bar since 1990. Why? Because it's called Snickers now. How long was that there for? Ladies and gentlemen, this house was filthy. It was so bad, I took off my shoes when I left. I wanted to keep London tidy. Summer holidays are coming up, right? I'm looking forward to it. Good things about going on holiday, you get to relax and hopefully you get some good weather, right? The bad part about holidays is when you come back, right? You come back, you spend all your money, you can't even afford to take yourself home. So what do? You call a mate and you plan ahead. I called my friend TJ. I said, TJ, listen, I'm coming back on Monday morning, 7 a.m., Heathrow Airport, Terminal 3. Can you please pick me up? The first thing liars do is answer immediately. Yeah, I got you, bruv. I was like, whoa. That was too quick. Monday morning, 7 a.m., okay, Terminal 3, Heathrow Airport. I need you to pick me up. He said, okay, ladies and gentlemen, I am now happy. I have made my plans. I'm cool. I get back to Heathrow Airport, ladies and gentlemen. The first thing that wound me up was how other people who were on my flight were greeted at the airport. There was a lady on my left. She came through the doors. Her husband was standing there. He had a board with her name on it. Sally. Sally met Dave, gave him a kiss on the cheek. They went home. Happy days. There was a man on my right on the flight, ladies and gentlemen. He came through. 17 of his family members turned up. And they all got into one Nissan Micra. I was like, this guy's a genius. And ladies and gentlemen, I had made my own plans too. I came through the door and I was like... I was fuming. I was waiting for 1 hour. After an hour, ladies and gentlemen, a mutual friend of mine and TJ's turned up at the airport. His name was Gavin. I said, Gavin, where's TJ? He's supposed to be picking me up. Is he at the airport? Gavin said, yes. And I was like, thank God. And Gavin then said, he's going to Jamaica for 2 weeks. I just dropped him off. Personally say to you, right, this is the final, but I want to say thank you for pressing that golden buzzer because you've changed my whole life. And in return, Simon, I would love to invite you to my church. But if you take me up on that offer, Simon, you have to cancel the rest of your plans. Because at my church, the finishing time is never the finishing time. For years, I used to blame my pastor at my church because I thought he was the reason why church was going on for so long. But it's nothing to do with him. It's the bloody choir. 16 choruses on one song. Ladies and gentlemen, I've seen Songs of Praise. They sing the songs for us. They've got things to do. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. They sing it quickly. Ladies and gentlemen, we sing the same song at my church, but we sing it like this. I said it. What is going on? Any normal church, right, if you don't have enough money for the basket, you just bring extra next week. Not my church, ladies and gentlemen. They've got a cash machine. They want your money now. I gave my pastor £10 because that's the most I could get, right? I gave my pastor £10. I said, Pastor, could I please have some change? He took my money and said, God will change your life. Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Kojo. God bless you all. Thank you very much.